We were already prepared for a very new NBA coming to the season, with the death of Golden State's super team and a million players finding new homes. But who would have guessed that there would be a new 24-year-old rookie undrafted player that scored 112 points in his first 5 games, the most since rookie Kevin Durant? Now you're probably wondering, 24 years old? Where the hell has this guy been for the past 6 years? In comparison, Giannis Antetokounmpo is the same age as him, has already won an MVP, and is entering his 7th season in the NBA. Well, the topic at hand is Miami rookie Kendrick Nunn, and where him and all of his talent have been for all these years. There's not much information on Nunn's childhood, aside from his father Melvin playing professionally in New Zealand. So let's go as far back as we can, 2009. Nunn's freshman year in high school at Simeon Career Academy in Chicago. Yes, that Simeon, where you may know a few other guys from. But we'll talk about that in a second. In 2009, 10 years ago, Nunn received his first scholarship offer from St. Louis University and was already listed in colleges such as Illinois, Marquette, Memphis, Ohio State, Oklahoma State, Texas A&M, and UCLA all at the top of his list. So this isn't some sort of CJ McCollum-esque story where the kid was vastly undersized and grows another foot to make the league. This guy's been pretty good. Over the course of his high school career, Nunn won 4 state titles alongside fellow Simeon teammate, current Atlanta Hawk, and former number 2 overall draft pick Jabari Parker. Nunn was also just one of 12 players to make it onto the Team USA Under 16 team in 2011 and went on to win a gold medal, and then once again won a gold medal with the Team Under 17 team in 2012 alongside Jabari Parker and Jahlil Okafor. Nunn's number 20 jersey and Parker's number 22 jerseys were actually retired by Simeon in their senior year, only the 4th and 5th jerseys retired by the school, joining 10-year NBA vet Bobby Simmons, a high school prodigy in Benji Wilson who was sadly passed away after being shot twice in 1984, and former NBA MVP and one of the most storied players of our generation, Derrick Rose. The 6'2", 175-pound Nunn was ranked as the 61st best player in the nation, 14th best shooting guard, and 2nd best player in Chicago, only trailing his teammate Jabari, in the ESPN Top 100 for the class of 2013. He was ranked in front of guys we've seen in the league for a couple of years now, such as Jordan Bell, Monte Morris, and Josh Hart. Nunn had committed to Texas A&M before his 2011 junior year, but then decommitted and committed to Illinois in 2012, staying closer to home. And now we move on to college at Illinois, where eventually things start to become pretty rocky for Kendrick Nunn. In his freshman year, Nunn averaged 6 points and 1 assist. In his first start, he scored 19 points and helped the team end an 8-game losing streak. He was awarded Big Ten Freshman of the Week for 2 consecutive weeks during the season, and after the season, Nunn was named onto the 2013-14 Big Ten All-Freshman team. In his sophomore year, he averaged 11 points and 2 assists. In his junior year, he was averaging 16 points and 2 assists on 39% from downtown, a pretty steady and solid progression from year to year. But in March of 2016, things took a drastic change. At 22 years old and in his junior year, Nunn was accused of choking his girlfriend and firmly denied the accusation, but did plead guilty to 1 misdemeanor battery charge, an accusation of pushing her down and pouring water on her. 2 other battery charges were dropped. Nunn was then dismissed from the Illinois team in May of 2016, but less than a month later he transferred to Oakland University in Michigan. Due to the NCAA's transfer rules, Nunn had to sit out the whole 2016-17 season, and instead complete his college tenure as a senior in 2017-18. In 2017-18, as a new member of the Oakland Golden Grizzlies, Nunn being the only member of the team that was even ranked in their respective top 100s after high school, he averaged roughly 26 points, 4 assists, and 5 rebounds on 44% from the field and 39% from downtown, finishing the season at 2nd in scoring in the whole nation, only trailing Trae Young. Nunn also led the NCAA in 3-point field goals per game with 4.47 and scored 30 or more points in 11 regular season games. He was selected as one of 5 finalists for the Jerry West Shooting Guard of the Year award. This was also as Nunn played through ankle tendonitis for the entire season. That one guilty misdemeanor battery charge would haunt Nunn though, throughout his whole senior year and further than that into his draft stock. His coach, Greg Camp at Oakland, said, "The tenor out there and what I've seen directed toward him, it's amazing. The words that people have shouted at him, the words that people have shouted at me, it's on him for the rest of his life. Every person he meets to treat them with dignity and respect and learn from his mistake. The bottom line is, he's got to live with that." An excerpt from a Detroit Free Press article from February of 2018 says, Nutt admits that the argument over $100, which he claimed that she owed him, has cost more than he imagined, including his reputation. Now as one of college basketball's emerging stars, he's trying to rebuild that reputation while chasing his NBA dream. After his senior year, of course, Nunn had to declare for the 2018 NBA draft. But despite an incredible senior year, factors such as the misdemeanor battery charge and even his 22-year-old age after 5 years spent within college basketball led to him going undrafted. Nunn would soon after sign a partially guaranteed deal with the reigning champion Golden State Warriors and find himself on the Santa Cruz Warriors G League team for the whole 2018-19 season. He put up roughly 19 points, 3 assists, and 4 rebounds on 47% from the field and 34% from downtown. He was also serving a 6-man role as he only started one of his team-high 49 games played. Following yet another impressive individual season from Nunn, this time in the pros, on April 10th of 2019, the last day of the season, Pat Riley and the Miami Heat scooped up Nunn on a deal that keeps him under contract until 2021, with a team option in the last year. And the rest is history. 6 months later, and Nunn truly put himself onto the map with a 40-point preseason performance, followed by a record-setting first 5 games where he put up the most points ever for an undrafted rookie, and the most points for any rookie since Kevin Durant, and he solidified himself as a starter for a Heat team that's been one of the best teams in the league early on in the season. For now though, this is where the story ends, and we're gonna have to see the rest of it play out for ourselves. Thank you for watching. You can drop a like and subscribe to the channel, all that stuff if you like the video, and I'm out.
Cut.